My name is Pablo Navarrete, and I am the director of Inside the Revolution, A Journey into the Heart of Venezuela. The reason why I decided to make this film about really the movement within the Chavez camp and not really concentrate on what was going on within the opposition was because I felt that so much of the journalism that we read and hear and see on Venezuela around the world in the mainstream media, and especially in the English language mainstream media, either focuses everything on Chavez, the individual, so the story, the Venezuelan story, if you want, is all about the whims of one man, you know, what he personally is doing with TV channels or whatever it is. And I also felt that the media reporting gave disproportionate space to those opposed to Chavez, both within Venezuela but also outside Venezuela, so that I felt that people in countries such as England, wherever, the US, were getting quite a distorted version of events. And this was really kind of reinforced during the time that I lived in Venezuela for a year and a half, between 2005 and 2007, where I initially started working as a researcher for John Pilger on a project called The War on Democracy, which looks at the historic relationship between the US and Latin America, and specifically the interventions against democracy by successive US governments. And for that research, I went out into the various low-income neighborhoods in Caracas and spoke to many of the people there who supported Chavez, because they're real bedrocks of support. Others didn't. But what I got from speaking to these people was quite a complex worldview about what was going on in Venezuela, why they supported him, why others didn't. And then when I looked at the media, I just got this very superficial narrative. So in a way, this documentary tries to provide a platform for this other Venezuela, this perhaps two-thirds, if we take the last election as an indicator of Chavez's support, to try and explore something within that movement, which I felt was, you know, as a journalist, something that hadn't been done. It's really surprising. I mean, before I went to Venezuela, I was very much your typical Guardian reader, if you want, would see Fox News and sort of laugh at a lot of the reporting that you see there because it's so ridiculous. But then, you know, look at the BBC and the Guardian and think, okay, well, that offers a much more balanced position in terms of what's going on in the world. And the surprising thing after living in Venezuela and seeing the reporting of, for example, the Guardian, unfortunately, has been that it's been really disappointing in the sense that it really does, obviously, it's not like Fox News and to that level, but it does in many ways replicate that kind of superficial reporting, often with lots of sort of factual inaccuracies, but also that kind of tendency to just to focus everything on Chavez, the individual, and for some strange reason and an unwillingness to explore a kind of more complex process, to go into the barriers, to talk to people, to try and do a journalism which is, you know, that tries to get into the story rather than just go for the easy option, which is to do it all around Chavez. I mean, as you see in the film, the role that the private media in Venezuela has played has been, shall we say, controversial to say the least. And then the way that this has been reported in the mainstream media in countries such as England, again in the US, isn't really doing fair to the facts, in the sense that, you know, the private media in Venezuela were key participants, key actors in facilitating and carrying out a coup against the democratically elected government. Now, I don't think anyone would suggest that the private media are allowed to do that in a democratic society. So then the question about whether Chavez is shutting down stations without, first of all, it's not quite the case, it's much more complex than that, but without mentioning or reporting on what the private media have done in Venezuela, it becomes very hard to understand what's going on in Venezuela. So I tried to offer an interpretation of that, of the role of the private media in the recent history, to the best of my knowledge. But I also tried to, in the documentary, have a part which also discussed the role of the media and its relationship to democracy that kind of transcended a little bit the case of Venezuela. I think after more than 11 years of having Chavez as president of Venezuela, the country's obviously changed a lot. It's been in the media spotlight like never before. I think there's been, in the main, there's been some very positive changes. I think there's been some very positive improvements in certain socioeconomic indicators such as poverty, unemployment. I think there are some very big problems that haven't been resolved. Issues of crime hasn't been resolved. The issue of corruption certainly hasn't been resolved. And I think these are big failings of the Chavez government. But these have to be balanced with these very big gains that have been made, sort of socioeconomic gains that have been made by very large sectors of society, which again are the kind of gains that are never reported. It's just the kind of problems, the crime and the corruption, which are reported, never the other side. So I think, what I would say the biggest change in Venezuela over these 11 years is not even the socioeconomic gains, because I think someone in the documentary, Joel, who grassroots organizer from Wincher Barrier on the outskirts of Caracas, said to me when I asked him what was the biggest gain, and he said political consciousness, which I found quite interesting, because he didn't mention poverty or unemployment. He alluded to this issue of now sort of previously excluded sectors feel that they're part of the political discourse of the country. And I think that that kind of psychological change is very hard to measure, it's very hard to quantify. But it, from my experience of living there, speaking to lots of different supporters in the barriers, it seemed to be that one of the major things they spoke about before not really feeling that the country was theirs, but now feeling that they had a place within Venezuela. And I think this is a real important prerequisite for, a kind of participatory democracy. If you watch the film, it's not a character-driven film, but I did want to at least give a flavour of three different types of constituencies in Venezuela. And I started actually with this rapper, Master, is his rap name, from Área 23, a rap group based at 23 de Enero, which is a barrier in Caracas. And I started with his kind of interview because I felt that it was interesting that he said what a lot of sort of 23-year-olds would say, was that, he was 15 at the time when Chavez came to power, and he said that, I didn't care, I wasn't interested in what was going on. But during the 10 years, he's become quite politicized and quite a strong supporter of the government, to the point that his band were invited on to Chavez's weekly TV show, where they, rapped about the coup d'etat against Chavez in 2002, but also did a spontaneous rap against the bureaucracy and the inefficiencies in the state, which, is extremely powerful, actually. And I think that the fact that someone like Master, has gone from a complete apathetic teenager to someone who is rapping about the bureaucracy and in the state institutions on live TV in front of Chavez in a very, direct way, I think it's a fascinating sort of journey. And I would maybe, it would be good to follow that journey in greater depth and sort of try and understand how that happened.